Tora, 1970 war film, co-produced by the US and Japanese filmmakers. It tells the story of Japan joining the Second World War, the events that led up to that point, and finally what was the starting point of the war on the Pacific, which was the attack on Pearl Harbor. The first thing that stands out in the film is how remarkably neutral it manages to be, opting not to take sides. That's probably in large part thanks to the fact that both American and Japanese filmmakers were involved in its production, but the result still stands. Neither side is painted as heroes or villains. It's mostly just two armies opposing each other because of the decisions of their governments. In fact, the movie is quite historically accurate with its depiction of Admiral Yamamoto and his unwillingness to start a war. So on the one hand, we have the Japanese preparing for war, but all the time undergoing internal frictions between the different factions that want war and those that don't. And there's another side to that internal conflict, which is the followers of old war doctrine and advocates of more modern tactics, heavily employing airplanes. On the other hand, we get to take a look at the American side of things and see how exactly they got caught with basically their pants down at peril. We see that many small errors, mistakes and acts of incompetence that prevented the army intelligence from being ready for the attack, which was definitely possible. Now, aside from the film being a co-production, there's another factor at play which I think helps it be more objective, and that is the fact that it uses an ensemble cast and tries to avoid humanizing its characters. The people we meet exclusively in their professional capacity as soldiers, generals, diplomats. We never really get any background on any of them, and so because of that, it's difficult to pick one or two and say, you know, this one's the main hero, like, this is the guy I'm going to be rooting for. Now, let's be honest, that's a risky thing to do, and normally I am an advocate of having a clear protagonist in a film, especially in war films. I think personal emotional engagement helps ground those stories. I mean, just take a look at Saving Private Ryan or 1917. And Tora was heavily criticized for this aspect, for being heartless and cold in this regard. But I think in this particular case, it somewhat works. It makes the movie more difficult to engage with on a personal level. And at times it seems more like a factual reconstruction of events than a dramatized story. But I appreciated it for this. It's also quite a long film, running at 2.5 hours. And most of that runtime is the setup, the procedural lead up to the decisive battle. And the last probably 30, 35 minutes of the film focuses on the events at Pearl itself. I think technically speaking, it's a marvel. It's kind of difficult to believe that something as convincing as this could have been made 50 years ago, but it was. The sheer amount of hardware on display, ships, planes, army bases, is just so impressive. Some of it was obviously done with models or mock-ups, but a lot of those were built to scale, which means the illusion is fully preserved. I bought into the film. There were times I thought, you know, I was watching real ships doing real exercises at sea and real planes in real dogfights. So there you have it, a war film that's very meticulous and matter-of-factly with its reconstruction of events, sacrificing personal human drama for historical accuracy and neutrality in terms of taking sides. And you can make an argument that those things make it flawed, but I think you can also make an equally strong case, and this would be my opinion, that it works and that it is a very good film.